In part one of this video series, I showed how to use Campbell Scientific's shortcut program generator to generate a wiring diagram that matches the existing wiring setup for a program that is already running. The sensors I added in that video were all found in the shortcut sensor list. In this video, I'll show how to add sensors that are not in the sensor list. My CR1000X is measuring a CS301 pyranometer, a 05103 wind monitor, a TE525 rain gauge, a HygroView 10 temperature and humidity sensor, and a Teros 11 soil water content sensor. All these sensors were added from the shortcut sensor list, except the Teros 11 water content sensor. When I search for Teros 11 in the sensor search box, no matches are found because the Teros 11 isn't sold by Campbell Scientific. I can still add this sensor to the wiring diagram, but first, I need more information. I need to know what type of output the Teros 11 provides, and I need to know the function and color of each wire. If I don't have a manual available, I can usually go to the manufacturer's website and download a user manual or specification sheet. In this case, the user manual for the Teros 11 gives the output as SDI12, and that the brown wire is power, the bare wire is power ground, and the orange wire is digital communication. That's what I need to know to finish my wiring diagram. Although Shortcut doesn't have the Teros 11 listed in sensors, it does have a category of sensors called generic measurements. I can use one of the options in that folder to create custom wiring for my diagram. If my sensor output is 4 to 20 milliamps, I will select one of the options in the 4 to 20 milliamp current input folder. If the output is a steady voltage, I select differential voltage or single-ended voltage. For variable voltage signals, I can select period average or a pulse measurement. Sensors that change resistance with changes to their environment have full bridge or half bridge circuitry, so I would select one of these bridge measurement options. In this case, I know the Teros 11 output is SDI12, so I double-click SDI12 sensor to open the sensor configuration window. In the Properties tab, I could select the number of result values that will be returned by the SDI12 sensor and even change the names to match the incoming data. But since I won't be sending this program to my CR1000X, it's okay to just leave everything at default settings. The Wiring tab is where I need to make modifications to create an accurate wiring diagram. The Wiring tab gives me information about the wire functions and where Shortcut assigns them to be connected, but not wire color information. I need to add that myself. I select the word power to open a wire properties window. From the wire color drop-down menu, I select brown. I could also change the wire description here by editing the field called wire caption. I will leave that at default and select OK. The SDI12 data line for the Teros 11 is orange, so I select data line and use the drop-down menu to change the color to orange and click OK. The ground wire is bare. I select the word ground and the color silver from the menu and select OK. The final change I need to make is that Shortcut assigned the orange data wire to channel C1. My photo shows it attached to channel C3. I click on C1, change the wire location to C3, and select OK. I select OK in the sensor configuration window to add the Teros 11 to my wiring diagram. The Teros 11 is still called SDI12 in my list of sensors, so I'll have to modify its name later. On the left side of the Shortcut screen, there is a category called Wiring where I can view the wiring diagram created by Shortcut. The Wiring Diagram option displays wiring information grouped by sensor. The Wiring Text option displays the same information grouped by data logger channel. Either can be sent to a printer or PDF file by selecting Print. Now I'm going to select Finish. After I name the program and select Save, Shortcut will generate a data logger program and ask if I want to send the program to a data logger. I select No because I never wanted the data logger program, just the wiring diagram. Shortcut gives me a warning that no outputs have been specified. That's okay, because I'm not sending my program to the data logger. The last thing I can do with Shortcut is copy the wiring information to program notes in CR Basic. I select the Summary tab and right-click anywhere in the Summary field. Then I select Copy to Clipboard. Now I can open the program I retrieved from the data logger and right-click anywhere in the program notes section at the top of the program and select Paste. I will delete the lines that are not related to wiring. I highlight the wiring information I just pasted and right-click on my selection, then choose Comment Block. When I save the CR Basic program, all the wiring information will be there in the notes. And that's all I need to do to create a wiring diagram using Shortcut. I'll talk more about using the CR Basic program notes section for a wiring diagram in a later video in this series.